Hi, my name is Kayla, and I'm going to show you how straights work. And I'm sorry. This is my ThingLink image, and I already have my tabs open, so I'm just going to show you what they are. So here it goes. So the first one is about how straights work, and for actually what a straight is. A straight is like a narrow, it's kind of like, as you think of, you know how like electricity moves through a conductor? That's what a straight is. It kind of allows water to flow through this two lands that have been separated or eroded. The lands can get eroded and just form a way so the water can come above. And what that is, it connects these two to each other. So it might, for example, of a strait would be the Atlantic Ocean connected to Gulf of Mexico. That's what a strait is. It allows water to flow from one body of water to another. So it's kind of like a conductor allowing two large bodies of water that connect into a navigable waterway. And so here's also what it was. And I'm going to read to you how, I'm not going to read from it, but I'm going to tell you how it forms. It connects two bodies of water, but you know those plates, how a volcano forms? Well, it's kind of like that, but it's different. These tectonic plates or shifts are formed by tectonic activity, and that's a strait. And when that shifts apart, the straits get eroded, and that's where the water comes above, and the land that used to be there is gone now. And these can shifts, the tectonic shapes that shifts can lead to straits like this. So that's how straits get formed. And it can also get formed by a large body of water. Have you ever thought how straits can like overflow and or has been eroded? So the land that had been subsided or eroded, how the land gets rubbed and rubbed together, and then it goes away. Well, that's what a strait can be formed, and then the water can come above. So that's how they can be formed. I will also explain to you a benefits of the straits. And some benefits of straits is that it helps protect, the straits support an estimated about the 3,000 species of marine life. So that's good because the straits can allow for more homes for the animals, for the marine life. Are these places where rivers meet the sea? So that's what I've been talking about. The Gulf of Mexico meets the Atlantic Ocean. So that's what I'm talking about. And again, this is my ThingLink. And this, I already told you how they formed and benefit. And here's a list of straits in the United States. And as you can see, there's a lot of straits in the United States. And like I'm gonna read you one of them, which is the Gate Pass and Puget Sound. But have you ever heard of this? The Erie Canal, that's between Lake Erie and the Hudson River and the Harlem River between Manhattan and the Bronx. But this, it connects the Harlem River. It connects to these, so. These are just lists of rivers or the straits that connect to others, but this is where it is. Like the Carquinez, I'm not sure if I'm saying this right, strait connects to the San Pablo Bay and the Susan Bay in California. So that's some things that connect to each other. Here's also a picture of a strait. As you can see, the water has either eroded, the land has eroded, or it has overflowed, which allows a strait form. I already showed you how they were formed, so you don't need to know that. And here's some more benefits of straits. So straits, they have a lot of benefits. I mean, like, they can have with the ecology, which helps with the animals and stuff like that. And what I read actually in here was that straits, they can help with when the army, where they are trading goods, it helps with importing the goods across. When you're in the army, it helps import the goods. So that's some stuff that what Straits does. So, I'm just gonna load this. And that's showing you, I already showed you the list, how they are, what they are. This shows an example of a benefit of a Strait. And I'm actually gonna click on there. Sorry, just let it load. So again, a benefit of a Strait is that it can connect two large bodies of water. So if you're in the army, you can transport goods and stuff like that. That's how they mostly get their goods, more like importing and stuff like that. So, I hope that you liked my lecture about Straits, and I hope that you learned a lot about it. And again, it's kind of like a conductor, so it leads water connected to another water. That's what I think of Straits mostly. So, here's my picture. I upload on my blog, of course. I'm under 18, so. There you go. So I hope you enjoyed my lecture about the Straits, and I hope that you learned a lot. So,